So we saw in Ephesians 6, we're in this spiritual battle. We see that we're trying to stand against the wiles of the devil. And in James chapter 4, the Bible says in verse 6, "But he giveth more grace, wherefore he saith, God resisteth the proud, but giveth grace unto the humble. Submit yourselves therefore to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you." See, as Satan is trying to tug at you and go in different directions, he's trying to pull you the wrong way. He's trying to get you to go where you shouldn't be going. You know, God's ground, you know, hopefully you're saved, you're standing on solid ground, and you're trying to hold that ground, and Satan's trying to pull you off. He's trying to get you to go off in another direction and make you fall on your face through sin. We need to be able to stand. And the Bible says if you resist the devil and you got this, you know, your armor on, you're able to withstand, eventually he's going to go away. And you know what that means? You're going to win. He's going to flee from you. So you're going to win that fight. You'll win that battle. You win that tug of war contest when he approaches you, trying to pull you off balance and trying to knock you out of the fight and try to pull you forward and pull you off whatever direction. Resist the devil. You got to strengthen up so no, he's not able to pull you back. And obviously we're talking about spiritually. And if you do that, you'll win. That's against that adversary. But you know what? He's not the only adversary we have. You can't blame everything in the world on the devil. Right? We still have the flesh. And a tug of war is going on daily between our spirit and our flesh. There's this constant battle. And we want to strengthen our spirit so that in our own internal tug of war game that's going on, where your flesh is going, man, I'm tired, right? And how about this? I was at a camp all week, and I was setting things up and taking things down, and we were going over here and doing this and doing that, and I was out in the sun. Man, am I tired. Whew. I get this, my flesh is going, go to bed. Go to sleep for like 20 hours. But the Spirit's saying, no, hey, it's church time. We're in church tonight. Let's stay with it. You know I'm tired. No, we got work to do still. We got a job to do. Let's not give into the flesh. Let's stay strong. Let's stand strong. I don't want to lose this tug of war with my flesh and just give in. Let's get some more motivation and get some more strength to endure and make it through. Obviously, this is one small thing, and I'm not trying to say anything mean to people that had to go home and do stuff. Look, I know there's a lot going on. My point is, we don't want to give in to the flesh, because it's easy to do. You start making allowances for the flesh when you're tired. Well, guess what? You open up that door. It's gonna be a lot easier than week after week going, well, you know what? I'm kind of tired this week too. Well, you know what? I stayed up too late. Well, okay. At least there's an afternoon service. I can make that one. Right? You don't want to start opening up that door and making those allowances. You want to stay strong. Because when you keep on giving up ground, you're going to find yourself moving closer and closer to losing that fight. And you keep on giving up ground. It's like, well, I'm a little tired now. And you're kind of giving up more ground. And before you know it, you're losing. You know, you need to stay strong. Bible says not to be weary in well-doing, right? There's a reward if you faint not. We need to stay in it and stay in, you know, and find the source of strength. We need to strengthen our spirit. The Bible says here in Romans 7, look at verse number 14, "For we know that the law is spiritual, but I am carnal, sold under sin. For that which I do, I allow not. For what I would, that do I not. But what I hate, that do I. If then I do that which I would not, I consent unto the law that is good. Now then it is no more I that do it, but sin that dwelleth in me." And we're going to keep reading here, but I just want to give it just a real quick explanation here, because the would and should and everything like that in the Bible, would just means, if you replace that with like want, what I want to do, that's what would means. It means what I would intend to do, what I want to do. It's not necessarily what I'm going to do the way that we use it today. So the things, basically saying, the things I really want to do, I find myself not being able to do those. And then the things I don't want to do, like, you know, the sinful things, I end up doing those things. It's like, I don't want to do that. I set up rules for myself. No, don't do that. But then I end up doing it. And he's explaining like this conundrum that he's in. He says, but then he explains, he says, well, you know, it's no more I that do it, but the sin that dwelleth in me. Verse 18 says, for I know that in me, that is in my flesh. And that clarification is very important there, the parenthetical clarification, so we understand exactly what he's talking about when he says that in me. He's not referring to the new man. He's talking about specifically in my flesh. In me, that is, in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing. There is no good thing in the natural man. The natural man can't please God. There's no good thing. The natural man is a sinner.